Hello everyone. In this video lecture, I will discuss a process of etching in IC fabrication. Etching is an important step in integrated circuit fabrication. Etching refers to the removal of material from the wafer surface. The process is usually combined with the lithography process in order to select specific areas on the wafer from which material is to be removed. So remember that in etching process, we remove a specific area from the silicon wafer. Etching also represents one way of permanently transferring the mask pattern from the photoresist to the wafer surface. There are two main types of etching. The first is wet etching and the second is dry etching. First, I am going to discuss wet etching. This is the schematic diagram of the wet etching process. In wet etching, the wafer is obviously silicon wafer. The silicon wafer immersed in a tank of the etchant. Etchant means it is called as a mixture of chemicals. A very popular etchant is potassium hydroxide, KOH. Here, our etchant is potassium hydroxide. So, when silicon wafer immersed in potassium hydroxide, there is a chemical reaction takes place between the solvent, potassium hydroxide, and the silicon wafer. In this process, either a photoresist layer or a hard mask like oxide layer is used to protect the rest of the wafers so that we can only remove the desired area in the surface of silicon wafer. The time for etching depends on the amount and types of materials that needs to be removed. This potassium hydroxide solvent is normally used as a 30% KOH solution, and generally it will take 5 to 6 hours to do complete etching process. After etching, the wafers are rinsed, usually in distilled water, for removal of etchant, and then finally dried. Wet etching is generally used for removal of material from a large area. Here, the large areas of wafer means typically you can say that greater than 2 micrometer. For smaller areas where greater precision is required in removal of material, dry etching is preferred. Wet etching process is anisotropic process. Anisotropic means the etch rate, that is the etching rate, you can say etching rate, the etch rate depends on the plane of the silicon wafer from which atoms are being removed. We have some challenges in etching process, and the most important challenge is incomplete etch. In incomplete etch, the time is not sufficient for complete material removal. This is usually due to the concentration or temperature not being sufficient. The second is over etch and undercutting. This is the opposite of incomplete etching. It means there is some over etch due to the fast etching and some undercutting inside the silicon wafer takes place. The third is etch selectivity. Etching process should be selective to the material that has to be removed. This helps to protect the material under the mask and also the mask material itself. So, the solvent and etching process should be determined the etch selectivity. These etching challenges are common to both wet and dry etching. However, these are more harder to control in the case of wet etching due to the higher rate of material removal compared to the dry etching. Controlling these challenges in dry etching are easier compared to the wet etching, because in wet etching rate is higher. Now the second is dry etching. Dry etching, as the name suggests, this is removal of material in the absence of solvent. The process was introduced because wet etching had some limitations in its applicability, and these limitation is, first, wet etching is used for large patterns, as we discussed earlier, that is usually larger than 2 micrometer. Second, the wet etching is an isotropic process. It means we are getting sloped side walls rather than straight walls. So there is less precision. The third is wet etch has to be combined with subsequent rinse and dry steps. So there is an extra steps which consumes time, that is called rinse and dry steps. This also increases the chance of defects or contamination. Fourth, hazardous chemical reactions and conditions are used, so safety is another issue in the case of wet etching. And fifth is undercutting and resist peel off that can happen if time is not controlled or etch conditions change during the process in case of wet etching. So dry etching is a process that overcomes some of these above discussed issues. Here, etchant gases are the primary medium for the removal of material. The basic steps involved are dry etching. We'll discuss in next video lecture. So here you can note that again, there are three main types of dry etching: plasma etch, ion beam milling, and reactive ion etch. Reactive ion etch is also called the RIE. According to your syllabus, in next video lecture, I will discuss the plasma etch and RIE, that is reaction ion etching. The steps involved in plasma etch and RIE etch is also called as the steps for the dry etching. Thank you.